Pascal's triangle is still a mystery today. It is full of patterns and simple ways to use it, but it is not simple. This is Pascal's triangle. There are the ones, counting numbers, triangular numbers, tetrahedral numbers, pentatope, 5-simplex, 6-simplex, and 7-simplex numbers. The counting numbers just go in order, 1, 2, 3, etc. The triangular numbers means that you need that many pieces to make a triangle. The tetrahedral numbers means you need that many pieces to make a tetrahedron. It is named after French mathematician Blaise Pascal. Pascal's triangle can be represented with the equation x plus y to the power of n, where n is the row number. This is how Pascal's triangle works. Imagine zeros at the end. Add 0 plus 1 and 1 plus 0 to get 1, 1. Add 0 plus 1 and 1 plus 1 and 1 plus 0 to get 1, 2, 1. It was recently discovered how to expand it to these kinds of polynomials. If you add up the numbers in each row, you get consecutive powers of 2. And if you treat each row as decimal expansion, you get consecutive powers of 11. Some of the things Pascal's triangle can find is probability, combinatorics, and coefficient of binomial expansion. This is the coefficient of binomial expansion for row 4. The exponents of x and y have to add up to the row number, in this case, 4. A fun pattern is that if you shade in all the odd numbers, you get a fractal called Sierpinski's triangle. This shows the golden ratio in the triangle. If you add up the numbers each line goes through, you end up with a Fibonacci sequence. And it continues. There are still many things to be discovered about Pascal's triangle, and as time goes on, we will find them.